Welcome to a new episode about Elementor Pro. Hello everybody, my name is Robert and in this video I will show you the preview of these 10 widgets. You can watch the previous episode by accessing the link in the description box, and before moving on, I want you to subscribe and ring the bell to get notified when I publish the next video. So, this is the flip box widget of Elementor Pro, which looks really nice and comes packed with lots of options. The content on the front could have an image as well as an icon above the title, but this feature is not available on the back side of it. You can use color, gradient, as well as image in the background for both sides, and if you carefully select the position and size of the image, you end up with a nice looking flip box. In the settings tab, you can change the height of the element, as well as the border radius. Then you can change the flip effect and direction. If I turn on the 3D depth effect, you can see that the content pops out over the image, and this works only for the flip effect. Of course, you can adjust the style of the content over here and make everything match with your entire page. The call to action widget comes next, and its purpose is to grab your visitors' attention and make them buy something or sign up for your newsletter. You can use the ribbon to say sign up for 10% discount at your first order or early booking, for example, then change the style over here. If you use this widget in a section with multiple columns, it looks like this, and you can create a travel agency page or website. When people click here, you can insert an affiliate link in this field and redirect them to the offer, which can be any product or service out there. The Media Carousel widget is ready for both image or video content. It comes with 5 slides as default, but you can add more below. You can change the effect, pick the number of slides per view or scroll on desktop, tablet, and mobile as well. In additional options, you can shut down the arrows, pick the pagination type, and many more things below. Testimonials are probably the best way to gain trust and increase the conversion rate for any service or product you may want to sell. This widget is simple yet powerful enough because it gives you everything you need to display what people think about your offer. You can put an image near the name and title, which are displayed below the testimonial text. And you can adjust the style of slides, content, image, and navigation separately in this tab. I will move to the following widget, but if you have questions or you want me to create a full tutorial about these widgets or other Elementor Pro features, please tell me what can I do for you in the comment section below. I would appreciate that. Reviews. These are again very important things to display on your website, no matter if you sell products or services. Honestly, I was expecting this to be something only with stars, but it looks more like the testimonial slider before. It shows you some stars below the name, which becomes active when changing the level of rating from 0.1 to 5. I think it works with 0.0. No, it doesn't show anything. You have to add at least one after 0. Now we can take a look at the Table of Contents widget, which could be a useful tool for pages full of documentation or any other type of content that contains a lot of text. It works as a navigation tool, and you can add anchors from H1 to H6. When you click on Elementor Pro, for example, it will jump straight to that H2 text on this page. Cool. We have 4 more widgets left in this video, and you can jump to the widget you want to see in action by using the timestamps in the description box. Let's take a look at the countdown widget, which can be due date type or evergreen timer. You can set the due date over here and shut down what you want to hide from the timer. There is an action after expire field below, which you can use to redirect visitors to a specific URL, hide the timer, or show a simple message. Style is something you already know, you can adjust for every widget. Here come the share buttons, which is a nice way to give people options for sharing your great content over social media and other places on the internet. You can add share to WhatsApp, Pinterest, Tumblr, and so on. Google Plus. I think Google Plus is shut down, so this feature is useless. The Blockquote widget is probably the simplest in this video, and it is exactly what it is. You can pick different skins in this drop-down and type in your text over here. Then you can set the author and adjust some view settings below. I think it's nice that you can set a target URL below. Here comes the Facebook button, which you can fully use only if you set your Facebook app ID in the integration settings. I won't go through these steps in this video, but if you guys want that, I will make a separate video, so let me know in the comments if it would be useful. You can turn on the share button as well as faces below and change some URL settings as well. This is it, guys. In the following video, I will show you the last 4 widgets in the Pro tab and how to use the 6 side widgets over here. Then in episode number 4, I will show you the single page widgets and how to create a custom blog post with Elementor Pro. Keep up the good work and see you in the next video. Cheers!